In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can identify interfering components in an Autodesk Inventor assembly. Here I have several components assembled, and I am going to go to the Inspect tab and choose the Analyze Interference tool. There's a couple of different ways I can use this tool. I can compare two different sets of objects, whether it's two components or two groups of components, or I can select a bunch of components at once. We'll first start with two groups. So for my first group, I'm just going to choose one component. I'll choose this component here. Then I'll select the Set To button, and I'll select a different component. Then click OK. If I have an interference, it'll give me some information, including its volume, and I can see a visual representation on screen. Another way that I can use this tool is to check all components in an assembly. If I select Analyze Interference, I'm only going to use Set 1 this time. I'll select every component. I'll do this in the model browser by selecting the first item, holding Shift, then selecting the last item. Then I'll click OK. As you can see, I actually have two interferences here that I need to fix. So now I can very easily go in and look at each area and see what's wrong. So as I look at this particular one, it looks like I just need to adjust the constraint that was used so that it no longer interferes. The other one though is a size issue, so I'm going to have to get in here and edit the underlying component and adjust the dimensions here so that I no longer have an interference. So I'll go ahead and analyze one more time. Once more, I'll select every object, then click OK. As you can see, I no longer have any interferences. We'll look at one more example. I'm going to analyze the interference of this assembly. Once more, I'll choose Analyze Interference, and I will select all objects as part of Set 1. Then click OK. So as you can see, it's not highlighting any interferences, but it does say there are a total of two. You'll notice down here that Threads has the number 2 behind it. I'm going to go ahead and select this to show the threads. So what I've got here is I do have technically a couple of interferences, but because they're threads, they actually don't interfere. It's because in the way in which they're modeled, the cylindrical shape is going to be modeled to the outer limits of the thread, but the hole is going to be modeled to the inner limits of the thread. Therefore, when we put these two parts together, they're going to cause an interference, but we know in reality that's because the threads are going to be in those areas and they will fasten together. So it allows us to clear that option and not worry about interferences between threads. That concludes this look at analyzing interference of assembly components in Autodesk Inventor.